Well, hello everybody, and a very, very friendly... Hello everybody, and welcome to another episode of VK Vins Q... and Anus, Q and Anus! And you maybe think, Q and Anus? What is this? The Q and Anus? Well, it's Q... and anus, and yeah, whatever. You ask the questions and I answer them. Q and anus, and then you think maybe what is up with the anus? What is up with the anus? I don't know, man. Well, I don't know. I know because to be honest, I'm a guy who likes the anus. And not so much of the man's anus, although I have nothing against it. That if you like the man's anus, that you must know, that, you know. But I'm a man who likes a little bit of anus once in a while, with a nice lady, if she has a nice anus, I like it, you know. But but you to lick it or to put a finger in it, I couldn't give a shit, you know. It's all good, and that's okay. I must know that, but it has to be a clean anus, of course. I don't like a dirty anus. some people do, but I don't. I don't like dirty anuses. Well, let's get the show on the road. As you may notice, and as you may know. I always have some food. Oh yeah, and my tafel, my table makes a little bit of noise, but yeah. I always have something for him to me, for during this this disastrous quest. I always have something to eat. And what do you have today, you ask? Well, today I have some spekkoek. Spekkoek, it's an Indonesian delicacy. In English, you may call it the bacon cake. It is the bacon cake. I don't know if you know it, but it's very nice. It's very nice. And for the drinks, I have it in my freezer. It's a 0.0 alcohol beer. It's very nice with the hot weather. Yeah, or you may drink it in the winter. You must know that. Well, let's get this show on the road. Or did I already said it? So, a lot of questions this week. And maybe because it was a special one. Because I do it in English. Did I already tell you I do it in English? Normally I do it in the Dutch. But now I do it in English. Lekker belangrijk. Yummy. It's of yummy importance. Hey, there we go. To the National Ombudsman, VK Vins. From Nora Meijers, or maybe an illusion. $100 bill. Nora multiple $100 bills. Huh. No. I have some very hard questions for you, which I'm going to ask you. Must I know? How do you know if you have had a previous life, or maybe have another life after this one? You don't. You forget when you go back, but you can remember. It all depends if you leave this planet in state of enlightenment, and if you stay in that state of enlightenment and you go back to the source when the death process of dying is in progress. If the process, yes. If you reach the light, if you reach the source, if you go back to the source. They say in the Book of the Dead. Fuck it. Who gives a fucking motherfucking... The Book of the Dead. There it is explained, but maybe the goal, I don't know if the goal is to reach enlightenment. Eventually, everybody will reach enlightenment sometime, not in this life, maybe in the afterlife or another life. We are bound to, and we're now in the stage of a great awakening, so maybe we will all get there or not. We must know that. And if you want to know about previous life, maybe you should look at Iboga. That's an African root, and Iboga is a medicine. Previous and after lives. Iboga, yes. But Iboga is very dangerous, very dangerous. You have to be really careful with that one. Or maybe you can look it up for yourself, Nora. Why do you ask me all these motherfucking questions? Yes. What do you think of the people who don't have a radio bath duck? Radio bath duck? A radio bath duck. Who don't want to adopt a radio bath duck? I think that is really antisocial. I must know that. Yeah, I don't think anything of those people. I don't give a. I couldn't give any lesser of a fucks than this. Yes. Is there a heaven and a hell, and when do you go where? Well, no. Yes, there's a heaven, there's a hell, and it's all here on Earth. We create heaven or hell. That's what it is. But not up there, eh? Not up there. When you go back to the source. You can go back to really dark places. So yeah, there's an heaven and a hell. And when do you go where? The Tibetan Book of the Dead. And you can read all about it. Well, these were my questions for this week. Must I know? Yes, you must know, Nora. this one is from Jos. Hello, Jos. What do you want to ask me? Let us see. As you may notice, I always prepare my Q&A analysis very, very goodly, so that I will know what will come. Because I had nothing much better to do than this. Yes, from Jos. Hello, Vincent. Thank you that you watch for a little while in the previous Ask Vaker Vince, in the previous Vraag voor Kans Vincent. That was the name of the show when it is the name of the show when it was in Dutch. But for the people who don't know the Dutch, then in English, it's different. Well, my girlfriend asked, why does everybody has to work to terwijl, while everybody vindt werken kut, when everybody thinks work is cunt. Well, you don't have to work. If you don't want to work, you don't have to work. And not everybody has to work. I think if you do work, then you're not doing something right. If you're not following your heart, if you work for a dead-end job that you don't like, then you really have a problem. So, why do you have to work? We were thrown into a system that is designed for a lot of people to have shit, lousy motherfucking jobs. It's up to you, man. Just do what you love, and the universe will fold itself around you. Good things will come when you follow your heart. When you give something back to the universe will load your motherfucking ass with a lot of good shit. Yeah. The universe must know that. No. So you don't have to work. And if you find your job fuckworthy, then don't do your job. Get the fuck out of there. Hello. I ask myself, have you any good tips for a mushroom or truffle journey? Yes, I do have a lot of good tips. Make yourself comfortable. Go in with a good intention. If it's your first one, zorg dat iemand watch over you. That you have a trip sitter and strawberries with the coconut flakes and the honey. Or a coconut blossom, coconut flowering, I don't know, or with powdered sugar. But I would go for the first one because the sugar. Yeah. Motherfuck my asshole. That I'm going to eat one of these days. Must I know? A very blessed thank you and hello. Well, hello to you too, my good friend Josh. Oh no, another big question for me, long question. I don't like long questions. I like short questions that don't take a lot of time, because otherwise we would be sitting here all fucking night, and we don't like that, do we? Do we like that? Do you like that? I couldn't give any motherfuck. I couldn't care less. No, I want to watch the football, the soccer, that's all. I don't usually vibrate in the matrix, but I watch the soccer World Cups and European Championships. I watch them. Must I know? A big friendly hello, Vincent. First, what a nice opportunity for the audience of the whole world to finally being able to understand your videos. Dat dacht ik ook. That was I was thinking too. From who is this? From Matthijs. Vanderleek. Van der Meer. Matthijs Vanderleek. Yes. I do feel bad for killing the smallest animals like mosquitoes and spiders. And therefore I do not do this. Unless I have no choice or by doing it on accident. So why are you telling us this? That's okay. It's very good of you. Don't kill any life forms without respect life, for it is sacred. We can notice pain in every life form, maybe even plants, but I don't know that yet. I know it. I definitely know that. Life is life, man. Life is life. La 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 la. La 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 la. Life is life. Why is nature designed to kill? There is no chance at all that life forms live together in harmony. Some species are designed to eat plants, others to eat other animals. Nature in its best way has an even balance of taking and giving to get the best of population numbers per species, and therefore all can thrive. Except for modern humans. We are a cancer for the planet in this way. Well, the humans are not, the ego is. My question is, if taking a life as an animal from another life form is needed to survive, why is it that both emotional and physical pain also plays a role? Why does every life form experience terrible feeling of being eaten when it is for the greater good and balance of the earth? Think of a planet without humans, or in the Stone Age with less humans. Best regards and hello, Matthijs. I don't know what the fuck's your question. If taking a life as an animal from another life form is needed to survive, why is it both emotional and physical pain also plays a role? It's a good question. I don't know, man. if you see how a lion kills like a zebra or something, they always go for the neck, so it causes as less pain as possible. The least amount of pain as possible. And it all has to do with respect. And, you know, the people in the jungle, the tribes in the jungle, they also eat animals. They kill the animals, but they do it with the deepest respect and humbleness and gratefulness. And they use every part of the animal, and they give back to the earth. So if you do it with that intention, then it's okay. A shaman once told me it doesn't matter if you eat plants or meat, as long as you do it with the respect. Yeah? It all has to do with respect. And and gratefulness and humbleness. And yeah. I think that's the way to go, man. That's the way you should live. Always. If you kill a motherfucker or not. But I think we all have a universal feeling of bad and good. And it all has to do with respect, man. And I think the animal life forms are maybe on another conscious. Maybe they are already in another consciousness than the human beings. Or we forgot what we are. Well, we have forgotten for a long time what we are. I think maybe the animals, they dwell in another state of consciousness, and therefore there is no karma in that layer of existence or reality or dimension. Maybe that is that an answer to your question? So not maybe you can ask a follow-up question or not. You must know that. So, what do we have here? Another Nora. Nora, multiple Holland $100 bills. What are you doing, Nora? I thought you don't send me too many questions in 1 week. Why should you do that? Or are you some stupid motherfucker? You don't know shit? No, I'm kidding. You can ask as many questions as you want, as long as you divide it upon the weeks. In the next week, I want only one question of you. You come up, act abnormally, please. Act abnormally for a little while. Act normally for a little while, effe. Whatever. Wat effe. Huh? Yeah. To the Lord Father of Earth and Space, the warrior of medicines, the soldier of love, and the descriptor of peace. Hello, hello, hello. Hello there, Veke and Vince. Very awesome to write you another letter, but this time in the English. Must I know? Are we doing the next Q&A-ness? En France? Oder Deutsch? Du solltest wissen. Maybe we can make this an international super show. Yeah, maybe we can. And maybe we won't. I couldn't care. I couldn't give any more facts. But I like it to do it. So and it's something different for a change. Yeah, we could do it always in the Dutch. But then the people in Holland maybe think, when he's going to finally go something in English, and the people in England they think, what is this motherfucker talking about? So yeah. How are you? I hope you're doing good. I am. If not, then you must know that. Yes. Anyway, here comes my question for this week. How do you get motivated for things? For the things you're not motivated for? I don't know. There's you're not motivated for, then you shouldn't be doing it. If you have the need to get motivated, then you're not doing something right. You must do it because you want to, not the first don't want to, and then you have to do something to you that you want to. It doesn't make sense. When is the best time to go to the toilet if there are no radio bed talkers around? And what to do if there is one? Yeah, well, just do your thing, man. Shit your guts empty. I couldn't care. What the fuck? You must know that. What name should I give my radio bed? Give some suggestions, please. Well, maybe the people on the other side of the camera can help you with your questions. It is your fucking radio bed. You should give him a name. Maybe you should call him Nora the Second. Nora the Second. Nora the Second, the radio bed talk. Yeah. Well, with a very friendly hello, everybody, and a very friendly hello, everybody. Must you know, hello from Nora. Well, that was a very nice letter from Nora once again. Eh? She sends a lot of letters. She is a nice one, the Nora. Eh? Hey. But where's your friend? Beirut? She has a friend in Beirut. And she was always ook on the letter, but now not anymore. So she must know that. From Django Jack. VK Vince, Q&A. Well, hello Vince. Oh, he starts in the Dutch and then he goes over to the English. It's very not to be understood by you people, but I will help to try to translate it, or nobody would understand a fucks. Hello Vince, my vraag was if you would like to choose for huge pussy flaps, but a little clitoris, or hardly any pussy flaps, but gigantic clitoris. What would you go for? That's a good question. I don't care. As long as it's a good pussy. Flaps. And a clitoris. I don't know. Who gives a shit? What is this for kind of a question? What do you kind of think of what the people do think of this? It's very hefty for some people, these questions. Some people can't handle these questions. I can handle them. Watch out there with the questions. I also want to vraag you your opinion about Amsterdam. A very friendly hello. Well, I don't have an opinion of Amsterdam. I don't like to go there too often anymore. I used to like to go there, but after the something in 2000, it kind of changed. It changed a bit with the people who populated the city. They were like with big monies and acting like they were super interesting or something. You know, if you have to act like you're super interesting, then you're not. You're interesting or you're not. You can't act like you're interesting. You can throw all the money that you want. Doesn't matter if you're interesting. You're interesting. Well, but you get it. So it's way too fucking busy, but it's a beautiful city. It's a very beautiful city, and it once was the most free thought city in the whole wide world, I think. Now with all the bullshit with the bullshit parade going on, I have my second doubts, but it once was. And of course the Hague also, and Scheveningen. From Steph Muller. Hello Steph. Dear Vincent, very blessed hello. Do you really think there's a real Spa Blauw in the nature water of the Ardennes? Or do you think that the fucking faggots just throw tap water in it? No, I really think... I don't know if this really is a supreme intelligence question, but well, no, I think it's real Spa Blauw. I do. Oh. Yes, this is this is always what I do. I first put them that they're really cold, and then I throw them in the freezer for like 15-20 minutes, so that it's really nice and cool, just the way I like it. As we say in Holland, proost, or cheerio, fuckface. From Sam Bymill. Sam Bymill. Hello, Vega Vince. I have a very important, intelligent question. Why are the bananas krom? Or why are bananas not straight? I really need to know, and please answer, but you must self know if you that for yourself. Yes. Well, Sam, it's very well known that the bananas grow to the sunlight. But you can find it on the Google also. Are you mother? Are you moron, Sam? Are you retarded? Are you retard? No, or maybe you are. From yes, from Shu. Hello, Faker Vince. I have a big important question for you. Since I'm working since the court in the horeca, in the restaurant business, yes. Yes, now with the mask bullshit parade, it is very cut. It is very cunt. Yes, it is. Any tips how to be nice, good, friendly, nice friends with the work people that I work with the people there? Yes, okay, thank you. Love and a hug, or not, you must know. Yeah, just be friendly to the people and make the most of it. That's the, and if you don't want to wear a fucking mouthpiece, then don't wear it. I never wear it. Why should you? If you don't want to wear it, don't do it. And that's the same as with the prikje. Don't get the prikje. Unless you really, really want to, but I wouldn't. I would wait for a couple of years and then watch what will happen with the people who take the prikje. I don't expect too much of it, but yeah. Maybe they really do have the best intentions for us. No. Well, yes, make a lot of fun in the horeca, because it's one of the best jobs you can have. You can make a lot of fun there with the people you work with and with the people who go there. Yeah, it is really gezellig. Yes, it's very nice and cozy. From Dead Boy Shadow. Dear Vincent, what was your favorite holiday location before the bullshit parade broke out? I'd like to hear about it in your videos. With kind regards, Sex Slave Shadow. Well, I don't have a really favorite holiday location. For me, every day is a holiday or a vacation. I just make the best of my day. But yeah, I've been through a lot of places, and I liked all of them. And I lived a year on the Dutch Antilles, and I liked the Curaçao. I like everything, man. I would like to go to the jungle one day and do like a 3 or 4 week dieta with the ayahuasca, maybe. That's what I would really like to do, and I would like to see the rest of the world too. But as long as the bullshit parade is going on, I'm not going anywhere, because I'm not taking the prikje. But I think it will be over very soon, yes. Must I know? So yes, sex slave, that is it. From Siep with the Sparks. It's from Siep Vonker. Siep with the Sparks. Hello, Vincent, and a very friendly. Oh, this I have to make it smaller so I can read everything. Hello, Vincent, and a very friendly. Hello. Because I have no questions left. Oh. I would like that you give an update about the merch and all that stuff. He's working on the website, man. He's working on the motherfucking website. I don't have it in hand, but if the website's ready, the merch is coming. The merch is coming. Another thing that I want to say is that I'm going to your cafe, even secret holder, this summer to show you the bot merch. Yes. Should I know? You see this motherfucker who makes a lot of releases. What the fuck is this? It's not normal. Doe even normal, gek. Act even normal, crazy. Hello. Very friendly hello and a very friendly hello and a really friendly hello. The greets from Siep. You have a lot of greets to Siep. Yes. A lot of greets for you. From Tess. From Elfen. From the Elves. Tess from the Alps. I have a question for your Q&A-ness. Q&A-ness? Oeh, dat was strange. Ah, fuck it. I was wondering if you have seen any kevers lately. What do you mean with kevers? And people in the... they don't understand what the kevers is. What is a kevers? I know. You mean the beetle. If you've seen the Beatles. And not the Beatles from... hello. And down Abbey Road. I don't know any Beatles songs, but something like that. No, that not Beatles, but she means the Dung Beetles. Because, I once made a video when I saw a beetle and I was running like an idiot to the beetle and I say, hello beetle, are you having nice walking fun? And the shit went viral and people like to watch the video. The people must know this. I haven't seen kevers lately. No. I don't think not more than you, weet je? Tess from the Alps? Yes. From Jack, from the Kuits. Jack from the calves. The Kouteren. Jack. Hello, my idol. I saw your video and I was wondering if you were enjoying your biological broccoli, your organic broccoli. Yeah, for the people who don't know what this is, why do this guy motherfucker ask me if I like the broccoli? Because I once make a video when I was acting cancer crazy like a motherfucker with the broccoli, and that shit went viral, and then the people like it, and you should watch it sometimes, although you may not understand any fucks of it, but. I think without, if you don't know the Dutch, if you don't know, if you can, maybe you will understand, you see what the crazy motherfucker I was acting like. Yeah, yes. I'm not going to answer this one. From Artie Farty Q&A is, dear VK to Vince, would you date a fan, asking for a friend? From Artie, would I do that? It would depend on all kinds of situations. It would depend on all kinds of situations. Huh. And bless my asshole and call me a lucky motherfucker. The last questions. From Wessel and from Sarah. From Sarah and Wessel. I think they're a couple or something. Dearest Vincent, a cue for your Q and anus. Can you sing a Michael Jackson song? Yes, I can. Hello. Well, that was it for today. Only 33 minutes. Can we make 33 seconds? Yes, I think we can. If you have a question, just send your question to your mother 43 at home to come with a friend here alone. Hello.